Hi, welcome to another edition of Marty's Place from beautiful Calgary. It's a great day out, and today I'm going to show how I plant tomatoes. These are cherry tomatoes, and I'm using a system that was given to me by a neighbor, and it seems to work really well. Now, I find tomatoes extremely difficult to grow in the Calgary climate, so I have the best luck with cherry tomatoes and sometimes Roma tomatoes, because I believe they're just a little bit on the smaller side. Now, other people may have better luck than I do, but I think they're probably buying plants that are in 12-inch containers and already 3 feet high. So it gives them a head start on the growing. So how the system works is, and I was able to build these with very little expense. So we have a wooden frame, and I put supports on it so I can tie off tomatoes or support them as they get bigger and bigger. And it's a very simple construction, rectangular, and all I did was pick up tongue and groove wood from the local Home Depot and cut it to fit using 2x2s and stained it with I believe it's golden oak. And it turned out really well, and I've made two of them. So one is already assembled, and so for the first part, what I would do is just like to show you how this system works. So it's called MaxiCap, and you use a fertilizer, and you put one cap in for about 40 liters of water. And the container, the growing container, it's like a self-watering system. It looks like a styrofoam cooler. Now this one was used last year, and I'm just going to reuse it. But inside the styrofoam container, you use a plastic liner, which I have here. So you just lay it in inside, and then put the lid on. And then you can either do it now or later, but this is a dirt bag. Seems kind of funny. that you just put on the top, and then the container, the wooden frame goes over it like so. And I've chosen probably the sunniest place in my yard that I can have to do this. As I said, I had started with one, and now I'm up to two, because this year I thought I would try maybe growing some peppers or something other than tomatoes. So each of these containers, you can put up to three potted tomatoes or peppers or whatever you're using to grow. And what I'll do is show you. You just need an X-Acto knife, and I'm just going to cut from this side. So you cut around, make an opening, there, and then sometimes I just put aside some of the dirt that I'll collect later, and I go in to the bottom, and there's holes, as I was showing earlier, in the top of the styrofoam cooler. That now I'm going to make an X cut, and it allows some of the dirt to go through, and then We all get our beautiful cherry tomato plant. I've had these for a couple of weeks now. And the idea is to push them in to the hole. This is where I'll use some of the extra dirt to pack around, like so. I hope that's in far enough. Would have helped if it was a little moister. And so we have the tomato planted, and now the idea is to fill the container, and there's a little fill hole right here, and fill it up until, I usually do it until it spills over, and then I know it is full. And about halfway through, what I'll do is add the fertilizer. Now there's a float, and mine fell on the ground here. So what you do is you can check it every day, but usually you can go a good week or more with the water in the container, and the root systems develop through the dirt into the fertilized water. So it's kind of like a hydroponic system, and as I said, it works really well. Yeah, so it's a little maintenance free, and as I said, I tend to get quite a few cherry tomatoes off it. And the thing with cherry tomatoes is you can have fun just snacking on them, stand out here on a beautiful day like today and enjoy, or pick a bunch for your salad. So I'll be back in a second once I get the water filled. Okay, sorry, we're back. So I've just filled the container full of water, and I've added a cap of the fertilizer. And the last thing that I'll do is just put a little splash of water, because they were quite dry, just on the top part of the tomato. And I may even try to push it down a little bit more to see how this, hopefully it will start to root in the water. So last year we were actually able to make some bruschetta that was just amazing, and that could be the topic of our next Marty's Place video, making bruschetta, but we'll have to wait probably a couple of months for that. These have a few little blossoms coming out, so hopefully they'll get growing here in this beautiful weather. So an interesting fact about tomatoes is apparently in Europe, in the Middle Ages, they actually stopped, a lot of places stopped eating tomatoes because they were using pewter plates. And what was happening was when they would cut the tomato, the acid from the tomato, because they are acidic, would react with the pewter, and the result was people were getting lead poisoning, because pewter is made with lead. One of the products that pewter is made of is lead. So I don't know how widespread that was, but this is just a kind of a fun fact that I found out about tomatoes. Anyways, until next time.